Boyajian Star, KIC 846-2852. Updates. The mystery continues. For a long time, extraterrestrial megastructures have piqued the interest of many experts and amateur astronomers. Tabby Star was one such huge draw. The strange lowering of light incident has sparked a flurry of speculation. Tabby Star, also known as Star KIC 846-2852, has been a source of fascination and investigation in the scientific community for quite some time, with scientists attempting to discover why it experiences unpredictable episodes of brightening and fading. We talked about the strangeness of Tabby Star in one of our previous videos, with possible explanations of the weird dimming of light, but more strangeness seems to have emerged from the new data of Tabby Star. Surprising evidence has been discovered that might help explain the enigma of this strangely fading star. So just sit back and relax while we explain to you the mysterious circumstances surrounding the star KIC 846-2852, or Tabby Star. NASA's Kepler mission has fundamentally altered the game when it comes to studying exoplanets and other distant worlds. It has observed around 530,000 stars to date. There are over 2,600 undiscovered exoplanets. One of these hundreds of thousands of stars jumps out as particularly odd. KIC 846-2852, commonly known as Tabby Star or Boyajian Star, possesses some of the universe's most unusual properties. Its flux drops by around 25%, which is 25 times more than what an exoplanet circling its star might do. It also fades gradually over decades, with unique brightening occurrences and no infrared emission, which all the other stars with large flux dips possess. Scientists were perplexed by these discoveries as they attempted to unravel the mystery. We talked about different possibilities, including the possibility of an alien megastructure in our previous video about the Tabby Star. But these things have taken a turn yet again. The star's behavior altered somewhat last month, and it appears to have entered a persistent 1% dimming stage. This is not typical of the star, which often shows short-term but frequently quite profound dips. In the Kepler data, for example, drops reached as high as 22%, but only lasted a few days or so. Instead, we've been experiencing a consistent plus or minus 1% drop for about a month. That also displays extremely brief intervals of recuperation, nearly the inverse mirror stage of what it generally does. Another feature of this 1% dimming is its shallowness. Since the Kepler mission, the dips in the star's brightness have tended to be lesser and weaker dimming episodes. This might be explained by a collisional scenario, such as colliding icy comets as proposed by Dr. Boyajian in the early days of this event. The difficulty is that this requires an impossibly large number of comets, or basically a big comet that is more akin to a planet disintegrating. But thus far, no models of this type have accurately anticipated what has been observed with this star. Another notable development with the present dimming is that one observer discovered that the material concealing the star during this dimming became optically thick for a brief period of time, effectively floating in and out of optical thickness. This was discovered by studying different wavelengths of light, and if true, it would imply that the dust cloud became much thicker and thinner as it passed in front of the star, yet stayed thick enough to keep the star visibly dimmed. Optical thickness may indicate a variety of things, including a massive solid object covering a star, such as a massive extraterrestrial megastructure. But in this case, it appears that the dust just became thick for a short period of time, confusing current ideas. But while unlikely, some kind of alien origin theory should be the last resort in our opinions. The point is, this star is acting unusually, even for dust phenomena. One especially perplexing element of this star is how the dust is still there in the system. The star has a long-term dimming tendency that is most likely related to the short-term dimming occurrences. After all, how plausible is it that two distinct but uncommon events will occur with the same star without being connected, especially when both entail dimming? However, investigations comparing different wavelengths of light absorption during dips have revealed that this dust is quite modest. This is submicron material that should be blasted out of the system on a regular basis. So whatever is going on appears to be replenishing the dust faster than it is being blown away, contradicting collisional models. On the other hand, the fact that the dips have lately gotten shallower than when Kepler discovered them appears to corroborate a collisional scenario in which objects are dispersing. Another interesting finding is that the drop appears to correspond with astronomers' estimates of periodicity. The establishment of periodicity is critical in determining what is going on with the star. Establishing periodicity would answer many unanswered questions, such as whether this is a phenomenon of interstellar dust that we are just witnessing from our vantage point, or whether it is truly in orbit around this star. Interstellar dust is implausible since we should notice it influencing nearer stars to KIC 846-2852 from our vantage point. A cloud at night does not obscure just one star, it obscures all neighboring stars from your vantage point. This is the same for the galaxies too. This is not observed, and whatever is going on is just affecting this single point-like star system, implying that the dust surrounding it is circling it. This orbit is critical, as it appears that the material obstructing Tabby's star is orbiting it within the star's habitable zone. The evidence for this appears to be mounting, but here's the rub. At the observed size of the dust, which is a very small smoke-like particle, it should be warming in infrared as well as blowing out of the system. No infrared emissions from this dust have been observed, and given the star's long-term dimming tendency of at least a century, some of it must be hanging around and should be shining with warmth. It appears not, but established periodicity will aid in sorting this out and maybe other information on whether the dust is genuinely chilly. The best natural idea for explaining the star's activity is some kind of collisional model in which cascades of material smash and form dust clouds. But it's difficult to imagine a technology that could do it continually through time. If you can recall, significant evidence for dips in the star's brightness have been found in previous sky surveys stretching from the 1930s to the 1970s, in addition to Kepler's observations and those made subsequently. Whatever is going on is happening in a continuous and long-term process. What that procedure is still a mystery, and it gets even more mysterious now with the new findings. Edward Schmidt discusses searches he's done through historical sky surveys to try to locate candidates acting similarly to KIC 846-2852 in a recent paper, which you can easily find in the description below. Schmidt had little trouble finding applicants. This is wonderful news for Tabby's star since those candidates may now be viewed and tracked. If they are caused by the same phenomena, observers will be able to gather a lot more data on various candidates and gain a much clearer picture of what's going on with these stars. In fact, he discovered that Tabby's star may be part of a compact cluster of about 15 stars that exhibit the same puzzling variations in brightness. The light curves of these stars, known as slow dippers, are extremely similar to Boyajian star, yet there's something strange about them. Two distinct patterns have arisen in this data that do not appear to be the result of random chance, albeit additional data and candidates are required to proceed. The first is that the candidate stars appear to group together. More and more of them appear to congregate in the surrounding vicinity of KIC 846-2852. This is not consistent with a random distribution of stars, and that's where this gets strange, because this is what you would expect from an expanding alien civilization. You might wonder, 15 stars, tightly clustered in the same part of the Milky Way, appear to be flickering in an unnatural way. Is this a technosignature of an advanced civilization? However, the clustering remains unusual. Naturally, the following question is the cause for the grouping superficial? And that the effect is caused by some intervening dust in the interstellar medium. This isn't the case, since once again you'd observe neighboring stars fading and experience the impact, which isn't visible. So whatever it is, it's happening immediately around these stars, and there is no reasonable justification for the apparent grouping, if it is truly genuine, as it appears to be. But then there's weirdness number two. The candidate stars cluster not just in space, but also in type on the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram. This is quite strange. All of the stars are either type F, like Tabby's, or type G, like the Sun. This does not appear to be the case for giant or tiny stars. On the surface, this makes no sense. You'd assume it happened with orange dwarfs, red dwarfs, and all kinds of stars. However, it's possible that those sorts of stars destroy material like this more efficiently than type F and G stars. But that's just a wild guess. However, it is worth mentioning that Type G stars are obviously really excellent for life, since we live next to one. And Type F stars are a bit shorter lived, but rather stable. And while they may not be ideal for life to develop around, they may be just great for aliens to inhabit and utilize. But it goes without saying that this development is a little strange, clustering in space and clustering in star classifications all at the same time. As a consequence, the article proposes that these new possibilities may be worthy of further investigation by SETI, and moreover, they should be investigated in general to attempt to figure out what this perplexing event that appears to happen to certain stars selectively is, whether natural or otherwise. When you think you've got a good hold on what's going on, you find out you don't. This has been the case for this celebrity since 2015, and I have no doubt that there will be more surprises in store. So what do you think about the continued strange behavior of Tabby's star? What possible explanation can account for such events? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. It encourages us to keep on making high-quality content for you.